before we get too far along in the module, let's step back and talk a little bit about what problem-based learning actually is as a pedagogical technique to help enhance teaching and learning. Well, it's been described as a teaching approach that really challenges students to learn, whether it's concepts or principles, by applying them to real-life problems. And I found that the best problems that we can present in class are typically ones where students don't know a lot about those types of problems. Maybe they're really current, maybe they're emerging, maybe they're ones that occur in a different country that students haven't traveled to. But again, it's challenging them to take what they know, what they've learned in maybe in the readings, in previous class periods, in previous courses, but forces them to think about how can we use this information to address problems in the future. In PBL, students must really use these problem-solving skills as well as their disciplinary knowledge to address the problems. And problem-solving skills is something that as future practitioners, whether they're going to be in agencies, industry, organizations, or in academic institutions, will be a critical professional skills that students will have to implement on a use on a day-to-day basis. One of my colleagues, Dr. Mark Ryan, the director for the School of Natural Resources and a professor of wildlife ecology at the University of Missouri Columbia, has used problem-based learning techniques for decades in a variety of different classes. And I've asked him to just provide some background on what he views problem-based learning is and how he uses it in his classroom.
Hi, I'm Mark Ryan, University of Missouri. I began using problem-based learning in my undergraduate wildlife conservation course about 15 years ago. I've enjoyed teaching with PBL, and I'm confident that my students are better prepared to be professional wildlife biologists because of their learning experience with problem-based learning. There are a lot of reasons why I'm convinced PBL is a powerful learning tool. Education theory tells us that people retain knowledge when it has meaning for them, and that students are more motivated to learn when they can see why information is important. So relevance and context is critical to the learning process. Additionally, we know that people build and retain knowledge, comprehension, and skills through meaningful practice. PBL is student-centered, involves active building of knowledge and comprehension, and I like that I can easily incorporate other active learning pedagogies like writing to learn or collaborative learning with it. I like how PBL, by introducing a case before the lectures begin, before reading and other assignments happen, creates context and relevance within authentic professional problem scenarios. Students then have a backdrop against which to assess and appreciate new information. This helps them link to prior knowledge, and it provides immediate context for seeing how concepts, facts, and so on are used in that professional milieu. It gets students practicing the art of problem solving in a professional context. So it's building professionalism along with knowledge. I keep talking about professionals. We know that professionals need more than knowledge and comprehension to be effective. They need higher order thinking skills. They need to analyze data, synthesize information from multiple sources, evaluate that data or information for its usefulness in a specific problem situation. And of course, ultimately, professionals have to have the ability to apply information to solve consequential problems. This is why they're being educated. Professionals in the wildlife field, and I would think most others, have to first be able to clearly define the problem to be addressed. They have to assess what is known, what needs to be learned. They brainstorm alternative solutions. What are the pros and cons of this solution or that one? To synthesize and evaluate disparate sources of different kinds of information. And finally, they have to craft and justify resolutions. This is exactly the process problem-based learning uses in the classroom. So PBL promotes long-term learning, enhances higher-order thinking, and provides practice in solving authentic problems. It develops professionals. In the words of my colleague Rick Campa, it doesn't just teach about wildlife biology, it teaches how to be a wildlife biologist.
So as we think about why we want to use problems in our classes and why problem-solving skills are important, an activity I like to do with my senior-level course that I teach at Michigan State University is to present students with a list of articles that were published in 1978. The reason I picked 1978 is because the class I teach is a senior level class, and in 1978 I was a senior wildlife management student. And these were the current or emerging topics that scientists in my field were publishing on. And so take a look at the list of the articles. Even though you may know nothing about wildlife ecology or management, think about just the general, your general impression of that list of published articles. And I might mention that the Journal of Wildlife Management is a top-tier journal in my field. This is a peer-reviewed journal, so it's where wildlife managers or biologists would publish. If we look at what's being published now in this journal, again, take a look at these articles. And can you think of some themes that might come out in terms of the types of articles that are published over time? So when I do this to my class, I have them think about it. And their observations are, well, the ones in 1978 seem pretty simple. They seem pretty observational, a lot of single species information. You jump forward in 2014, the articles are using a lot of technology. They're interested in higher level quantitative analysis or modeling. There's some international topics. They're much more complex, so to speak, problems than in 1978. So that the challenge is, and what I share with my students is, what's going to be the next issues for them in the next 36 years, which is basically their professional career. And giving us, or stepping back and thinking about not necessarily the facts that we're learning in our class that are important, but how we're going to deal with those problems, how we're going to solve problems, the process of solving problems, is what's important. And how do you integrate those problem-solving skills with your disciplinary skills to help you prepare for whatever those problems are going to look like in the next 36 years? So in my own field, a few quick examples that are kind of current emerging issues: managing rare or unique species in habitats that are also occasionally impacted by human use, wildlife conflicts, whether it's for ecotourism, whether it's by development, could be for a variety of persons, wildlife disease ecology and impacts to humans. You've probably seen a lot in the news on global warming issues, and probably many of you participate in research projects that deal with various aspects of global warming in your own fields.